Lord, we worship you. We bless your name, Lord, for this morning service. Thank you, Elohim. We glorify your name for a new day. Blessed be God for that you've done. We worship you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Today is my birthday, and we trust the Lord. We started our campaign, 540 subscribers. So it's on Friday, so today is the last day. We are making a campaign. It's also my birthday. So if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, we're trusting the Lord for 540 subscribers for my birthday, to celebrate my birthday. So if not done that, before you continue watching the message, just go and click that button, subscribe button, and celebrate with me. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, before I go, I want to appreciate also my partner Fantasia. They're in Lake Lagos. They keep making clothing for me, and in fact they just have to make sure they deliver this over my birthday. They brought about three of them for my birthday. Fantasia will love you. This is your Fantasia, and the entire crew member, workers of Fantasia will love you, will cherish you. May the Lord bless and prosper your business in the mighty name of Jesus. Now let's go straight to the word of God this morning. Today, now I'll be preaching on the message titled "The Shekinah Glory." The Shekinah Glory. When we talk about the Shekinah glory, we are actually referring to the total glory of God. When you hear the word Shekinah, means the actual manifestation of His glory, the fullness of His glory. And I'll be taking our text from the book of Exodus, the 13th chapter. Moses saw the Shekinah glory of God. There's no way you can see the Shekinah glory of God and remain the same. Now, Exodus chapter 13, verse 21. See, and the Lord went before them by day in the pillar of cloud to lead them the ways, and by night in the pillar of fire to give them light to go by day and night. That is the glory, the Shekinah glory. If it was visible, in verse 22, he took not away the pillar of the cloud by day, nor the pillar of fire by night from before the people. God appeared with Shekinah glory. Oftentimes, you look as if you are confused. You don't know where to turn to. Ask for the Shekinah glory of the Lord. He will lighten your way. He will make everything work in your perfect your way. Now, what is the Shekinah glory? Shekinah glory is the visible manifestation of God Almighty. Shekinah glory is the visible manifestation of God Almighty here on earth. Now, people who say they died, or maybe they went to heaven and saw Jesus, they saw the light, the glory. They couldn't behold Jesus. They couldn't behold the true where God is. So the Shekinah glory is the manifestation of God Almighty here on earth. And it comes most time with a natural occurrence. It comes most time with natural occurrence. Something visible that you can see. It is also known as the divine presence of God in man's life. The Shekinah glory also means the divine presence of God. When God presents at tabernacle where you live, or tabernacle as you go out, you could see the glory. Men that walk through on earth, ministers of God, women of God, they've seen the Shekinah glory. I heard about Catherine Kuma. You see, most of when he's walking, he can see the glory like a blanket covering her. No wonder when Catherine Kuma enter the meeting, people are going to follow the anointing. Why? The Shekinah glory. Without the Shekinah glory, we are empty. It is the Shekinah glory that makes the difference. It is the Shekinah glory that attracts men to us. Today be my birthday. Since 3 days I've been, oh God, give, show me your glory. I want to see your glory. Moses say, if your glory will not go with us, don't bother us to even go. Without your glory, how can we continue this journey? We need the Shekinah glory. We need the glory to fall upon us, that people can see, men can see that we have contacted the grace of God. Who are the men that I've seen in the Shekinah glory in their life? People like Brother William Brigham. William Brigham experienced the kind of glory that no one has seen before. It's so visible that the evidence is they can see. The camera even snap the evidence. At times when he's pushing, Brother William Brigham is pushing, you could see the glory over his head. You could see the light over his head. Elias, one of the greatest, his greatest prophet, seer that God have raised in our generation for his birth, before he died. Will Abraham will be prophesying, will be discussing with you as if he knew, he have known you many years ago. Asking, for example, would you look at you say, John, please come here. What of your brother Andrew when you left at home? Why is this tender in watching TV? He'll be discussing with you. Now, because of his glory have covered, when the glory of the Lord, the coming glory of the Lord comes upon you, he opened up the holiest of holy for you to see things and begin to manifest his glory. So Brother William Branham saw his glory, saw that Shekinah glory appear to him either in his meeting, wherever he is. When the time the Shekinah glory appear, people can see that this is of God. And that's what I'm preaching to you today. May you experience the Shekinah glory in your life and ministry in the mighty name of Jesus. People like also A. Allen. A. Allen experienced the Shekinah glory of God. The Shekinah glory, like I said, is the visible manifestation of God. Something that you cannot explain. Something, some mechanical. It's not something that says, this is what I want to do. Or it must occur. No, you don't plan for it. Many years ago, I was in Germany preaching around 12 midnight, I was just watching YouTube, watching A. Allen. And Kashi Kuma was about to introduce him for the meeting. I think it was 19, maybe 97 something or 70. He was about to introduce him for the meeting. And as A. Allen was sitting down with his Bible, holding his Bible like this, all of a sudden his Bible went with oil. Now there was no oil, and as he came to the pulpit, to the podium, as he holding the Bible, his hand was dropping of oil. That is the presence of God. Not that he rubbed with oil. You can see the oil dropping off his hand. The anointing. And everybody will look at what kind of a man is this. No wonder that ALM will look and say, where are the blind? They will bring the people and the witches. And as they come, begin to lay hand upon them one by one. And they get up. That is the eternal glory of God. When the presence comes upon you, man, miracle follows. It's like God himself coming down to manifest. There is no way you can see the glory of God without you not seeing his change. The Shekinah glory. Great men of God that walked through on earth have seen that glory move in their life. The Shekinah glory is, in English, word is translated in Hebrew word as the dwelling or settling of God's divine presence. The dwelling and settling. When the glory comes, when his glory settles on you, it dwells on you. That is Shekinah. That you can't explain it. Joshua saw his glory and he couldn't understand. That's why they call him Yahweh. They lack the English word, they lack vowel to call him Yahweh. They call him Yahweh. The Almighty, his presence. When his presence come before you, who is that devil that can stand before you? The Shekinah glory. The Shekinah glory. And I trust the Lord that you're going to encounter. See, in this end time that we are, people that will move on unstoppable are men and women that will carry the Shekinah glory of God. Are people who will walk into a place and they will see God move like never before. People will just walk into a place and everywhere begin to shake. Atmosphere begin to shake. The glory of the Lord. Many years ago, as some under pastor Iya Deboye of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, he was sharing a testimony, which was a true life testimony, that the founder of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, they were in Tulsa, Oklahoma, they were just worshiping the Lord in a 5-star hotel, I think the last floor. They were worshiping the Lord with a tambourine, and all of a sudden, the Shekinah glory of God came down in that room. And history said that the foundation of the hotel was shaking, and the engineer began to trace where the sound was coming from. And they went to that room, they found that the sound was coming from that room, the shaking was coming from that room. That was the Shekinah glory. It was not only them, but the angel of God came. And they say, what kind of instrument, what kind of thing that is playing, that is vibrating the foundation? And they searched the room, they only saw a tambourine that they use in praising the Lord. And they did not turn and look at them. And history said that hotel was closed for years. Because they couldn't fathom, they couldn't understand, how can a tambourine shake the foundation of the hotel? They had to shut down the hotel for safety. Well, it was a Shekinah glory of God that came, and it was that day that God told the founder transfer power to Pastor Iya Deboye. When you see the Shekinah glory, it is not hidden. The glory is not hidden. You can see, you can, you see, it's like a blanket, you can touch it. The Shekinah glory of God. May you experience it in your ministry as a pastor, as an evangelist, as a minister of God. May you experience that Shekinah glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, what are the keys to experience Shekinah glory? The keys. Number one key I want to show you, seek God through prayers. Number one key, seek God through prayers. When you seek God through prayers, you begin to see His glory, you begin to see His power. Tabernacle. You can ikabayata. There's no way you can see His glory without praying. You, number one, you must seek God through prayers. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. And I trust the Lord that His glory will come upon you mightily. You need to seek Him through prayer. Pray, see, Shekinah glory does not just come by you just eating and drinking. Set a time apart to begin to pray. Act of Apostle chapter 1. Let's see the Bible. Act of Apostle. Hallelujah. Act of Apostle. Now, Act of Apostle is where the power of God was, that's where the promise of God came. So tarry in Jerusalem until you endure with the power from high. Acts chapter 1 verse 8. Look at it in the Bible. He said, but you shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and you shall witness unto me both in Jerusalem and in Judah and in Samaria and unto the utmost part of the earth. The Shekinah glory. He said, don't go to the apostle, don't go until you see the glory, until you see the power come. Katalabana hashata. Are you with me? And Jesus began to say, and when they have spoken these things, while they beheld, it was taken away. Now, after Jesus was arrested, it was taken away. And the cloud received him out of the side. Now, look at the promise of God. Hallelujah. Verse 10. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven, as it went up, behold, two men stood by them in with white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner, in that glory, in Shekinah glory, in like manner, as ye have seen him go. So, why are they not generated? They begin to pray, they begin to seek the Lord, seeking God through prayers. In verse 12, it says, then returned they unto Jerusalem from the mount called Olives, and which was from Jerusalem a Sabbath day journey. Verse 13, and when they were come into inn, they went up into upper rooms where abode Peter and James and John and Andrews, Philip and Timothy, Bartholomew and Matthew, James and son of Alphaeus, and Simon Zealot, and Judas the brother of James. This all continue. When it continues, they were seeking the Lord in prayers. So your number one key is to seek the Lord. To seek the Lord through prayer. They were seeking the Lord through prayers. Night and day, waiting upon the promise to see the Shekinah glory. And all they continue with one accord in prayers and supplication with the woman and Mary, the mother of Jesus, with them, with his brethren. Look at verse 15. Look at verse 15. And in those days, Peter stood up in the midst of the disciples and said, the number of names together were about 120. You think about 500 people gathered, but only 120 waited for the promise and they saw the Shekinah glory. The disciples needed to encounter the Shekinah glory of God based on Jesus Christ's promise to them that tarry ye in Jerusalem until the Holy Ghost comes upon you. Now look at Acts chapter 2. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 2. Verse 1. I'm going to run with it. Verse 1. It says, and when the days of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. The glory, the Shekinah glory came. Hallelujah. In verse 3, and there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. It is visible that they can see it. The Shekinah glory. That to the prayer people were marvel. They were surprised. this be God? You need the Spirit today. In the name of Jesus. Number two, keys. Enter the right atmosphere. You see, the apostles were in the right atmosphere until the glory came. Enter the right atmosphere. Enter the right atmosphere. You cannot be in a nightclub and expect the second glory to come. No. Be in the right atmosphere. Exclude there for to hear God. Mark Gospel. I'm about to round up. Mark Gospel. Let's see Jesus Christ with the disciple. What happened? And the glory, the Shekinah glory, the experience, the Shekinah glory. Mark Gospel chapter 9. Mark Gospel chapter 9. In verse 2. After 6 days, Jesus took it with him, Peter, and James, and John, and led them into on a high mountain apart from themselves. And he was transfigured before them. In their eyes, he was transfigured. And his raiment became shining, exceeding white as snow. So as no food and no soap on earth can wash that cloth. It was too white, too bright. Why? The Shekinah glory. And there appeared unto Elisha with Moses and they were talking with Jesus. Now, where did Elijah appear? Where did Moses appear? Elijah talks about the prophet. Now, the Moses talk about the law. When Elijah appeared, it's representative of the prophet. And when Moses appeared, it was the fulfillment of law. Jesus said, I didn't come to turn it to break the law, but I come to fulfill the law. It was so visible that the disciples saw it and they were shaking. Hallelujah. Verse 5. And Peter answered and said to Jesus, Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us make 3 tabernacles, one for thee, and one for Moses, and one for Elisha. The Shekinah glory. They saw the Shekinah glory. Number 3, you must be expectant. You must be expecting. You must wait. I'm waiting for the glory. I need the glory. You must be expectant about fasting and prayer, waiting for the day, for the fulfillment until the glory comes. You must be expectant of the glory, or the Shekinah glory. Hallelujah. Number 4, lastly, ask God for His mercy. It's of His mercy that will not consume. And people can wait for 100 days, they didn't see the glory. But yes, someone can wait for only 7 days and the glory, the Shekinah glory appear. It's of His mercy. Romans is of His mercy. Because the mercy of God is the medicine of God. We need His mercy to manifest the Shekinah glory. So we need to ask God for His mercy. Ask God for His mercy. Let His mercy speak for us. Romans chapter 9, verse 15. It says, for He said to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. That is the mercy of God. It is God that chooses ourselves. As I round up today, if you don't know Jesus, you're going to say, Lord Jesus, I need Your mercy. Let Your mercy speak for me, Lord. You that is washing me right now, or you're going to wash me later, going to say, dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner and no repentance. Have mercy on me and wash me with the blood of the Lamb. Devil, I reject you. I declare that I belong to Jesus. I say with my mouth that Jesus Christ died and rose up on the third day just for my sake. Thank You for saving me in Jesus' name. Now, Father, I thank You and bless Your name for this one. Lord, affirm that word. Keep them, O God, from the hands of the wicked. Lord, save their soul and give them the joy of salvation. Thank You, my God, my Father, for saving their soul. In Jesus' name. Now, congratulations for you giving your life to Jesus. I appreciate you. I've done that many years ago. As a matter of fact, I used to be a DJ in nightclub, and God called me and I surrendered my life. That's why I'm preaching to you right now. Alright, so you didn't miss it. You're in the right company, in the right environment, in the right team. From henceforth, the fresh oil is upon your head in the mighty name of Jesus. Please do write to us, to our go to our website, write to us. Let us know that you got saved through telecast. I'm going to send you some material that you're going to help you in this Christian journey. And I trust God the Lord that you'll be greater than I and the voice of God will speak through you. Greater prophet than I is about to come through your life. In the name of Jesus. Let us know how the Lord is doing, how you are doing with the Lord, and we're going to begin to follow you day and night in prayers. Also go to, if you are watching me, go to our website, also get subscribe for our newsletter. We're going to be sending a newsletter to encourage you when the last day is, when the last day, that everyone need an encouragement. Everyone need an encouragement when the last day is. You need a word that can encourage you, that can keep you safe from this world. Praise Jesus. Now today is Sunday. If you want to give your offering, wherever you are, any country you are free to give your offering in any currency. I want you to go to our website and just go to place called donate or partner with us and just fill out this form and make your offering or donation. And the Lord's going to bless you. Father, we thank you, bless your name, we'll give you praise. Lord, bless this offering in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for our online givers. Lord, their seed, oh God, will speak for them in the gate of their enemies. In the name of Jesus, worship you in Jesus' name. Now, congratulations. Please don't forget, go to our Amazon books and get our books. There's some of our books are there. Also go to our website or Google store. You can get our books. Read them. It will bless you. This time we are now, you need the word of God to enter inside you. And as you do that, we trust the Lord that grace will begin to speak for you in the mighty name of Jesus. You are my brother, you are my friend. We'll celebrate you and the reason why we came. Please keep in date with us on Thursday. This Thursday, we are coming to you again with another message. Remember, no matter what matters, the same God is at work in your life. I see you on Thursday, sometime. Shalom. Bye-bye.